Coming up in this special Brightline construction update. This special Brightline construction update looks at days 13 through 15 of the installation of the Cocoa Tunnel, which occurred from March 27th to the 29th, 2021. The Cocoa Tunnel is located at the interchange between State Road 528 and US 1 in Cocoa, Florida, and is where Brightline's new line to Orlando will separate from the existing Florida East Coast Railway main line to head west. We'll start here on day 13, March 27th. Not much seemed to have changed since my last video. Segment 3 is still sitting alongside the other two segments that are already being installed. The other two segments have only moved forward slightly. This tunnel is being installed using a method called box jacking, which uses hydraulic jacks to push prefabricated tunnel segments into place. This installation is special, as it is the first time in North America that segments have been pushed into place while there is an active highway passing over it. This is possible due to an anti-drag system, which is a series of metal plates laid on the roof of the tunnel segments with a lubricant underneath and held in place by the dark blue frame straddling the tunnel. The dark blue frame is held into place by large concrete anchors on either side of the tunnel. One can be seen here. On the tracks behind the worksite, the Florida East Coast Railway's unit train can be seen as it is being unloaded. When this train arrives here as train 336, FEC turns it over to CMEX crews who unload it by remote control, which is what is happening here. After a few more cars, it will back up to wait for a new FEC crew to arrive and take it south as train 335 that night. From the north, here's a look at the excavation of the old westbound lanes of State Road 528. Day 14, March 28th, looked almost the same as the previous day. The only visible progress seemed to be crews continuing to excavate the former westbound lanes of State Road 528. While it may seem like they are taking forever to excavate this area, there's a reason they are taking their time. Once the segments are pushed off the concrete pad they are built on, they are moving solely on dirt. In order to control the movement of the tunnel segments as they push forward, crews change how the earth in front of them is excavated. The first tunnel segment was built with an overhanging angle. Using this angle, the segment can rise if additional dirt is left in its path, or lower if dirt is removed in front of it. Crews take measurements at least hourly, if not more frequently, while the segments are being pushed to ensure the tunnel will be straight and level when complete. So with this in mind, the excavation will not be complete until the tunnel is installed. This tunnel is being installed using three separate segments that will be combined. The first is completely under the road currently, and the second is attached to it and being pushed on. The third is the one off to the side, waiting to be combined with the others. Looking down at the jacking equipment shows the same positioning as the day before. Work is going to be speeding up as crews were arriving and having a pre-shift meeting as I was finishing up my flight for the day. Here's a look back into the job site from the north. Moving on to day 15, March 29th, and there was a lot of change. Crews had finished pushing the first two segments far enough forward so that they would be clear of the lateral movement of segment 3. Segment 3 was actively in the process of finishing the lateral movement so that it would be in line with the other two segments. Here, a mini excavator is moving the light blue beams over towards the jacks. After the jacks make it to their maximum extension, which I guess is about 1-2 feet, these small beams are dropped into the resulting gap. That process is repeated until the distance is long enough for the longer rods to be placed there. When operating at the maximum speed possible, crews are able to move the segments about 3 feet an hour. That ends up being about half an inch a minute. With speeds that slow, it might not look like the segment is moving, but it is. Here's a look down from the east side. You can see the joint between the two segments here. Around the edge of the segments looks to be metal plates, and the joint will be waterproofed in some fashion before it is installed. Moving over, these are some of the jacks that are used to move the segments. The blue box is the hydraulic control unit that operates the jacks. Crews here are working to install a thin piece in between two of the beams. The jacks are placed against the tunnel segment and are pushing back against a small concrete wall and a pile of dirt. Once this push is completed, the rods and beams will be removed and staged to be used to finish pushing the combined three segments into place. To wrap up this update, here is FEC Local Train 916 reversing its train into City Point after it had finished working a few miles south at the Coco Rockledge Yard. Locomotive 511, which is an EMD GP38-2, is one of the last locomotives to wear the large Going Places in Florida logo paint scheme. As it passes the worksite, it and the tunnel really are a link between the past and future and the overall story of railroading in this area. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.